The difference between hydrophilic and hydrophobic is actually pretty simple if you look really at the actual name here. So we've got hydrophilic and hydrophobic. So as you know, phobia, if you have some kind of fear, phobic means that there's a fear of water, and hydro is obviously water. Now, philic is the love for or attraction to water. So if you really just look at the word itself, it will tell you the meaning of that actual word. Now, a hydrophilic molecule loves water. Hydrophobic ones hate water. We have something that's called the contact angle here. And this is kind of what tells us how hydrophilic or hydrophobic a substance can be. So if we have a small contact angle here, like you see there's some kind of acute angle there, you'll actually notice that this is actually more hydrophilic, whereas a hydrophobic substance is gonna repel water, creating a larger contact angle. So you get this obtuse contact angle there. Now, some examples of hydrophilic molecules are polar molecules, ionic compounds, sugars, carbs, acids, and hydrophobic compounds are like nonpolar hydrocarbons, lipids, fats, kind of like a good example is that actual phospholipid bilayer. You can see that here we've actually got the hydrophilic head with the hydrophobic tails. So those hydrophobic tails are actually going to be inside of that phospholipid bilayer, and then those hydrophilic heads are going to be actually on the outside with water out here. So you can see that these hydrophobic tails are kind of, you know, pushed away from the water's edge because they don't want to be around there.